That's a very good idea. It's the Z-tone control and impedance control, and it's one of the main features on this quite wonderful Axe I/O interface, specifically made for guitar players, from IK Multimedia, my friends in Italy. Hello, Tia, and everybody over there at IK Multimedia. So what have we got? Well, basically, it's a two-in and four-out interface with USB up to 192K. But the great thing is that this input 1 has an impedance control, which they call from sharp to bold, and also a little preamp control here, JFET or Pure. And it's going to very subtly tailor the sound of your passive or active pickups, passive if you want to use the Z-tone control. And it makes, you know, quite a lot of difference. This is a standard PRS Studio with a kind of a PAF 5708 in the back. And I'm running into Amplitube's own Vibroverb amp sim, which is really nice. A nice clean sound, so I can show you what this does. So at the moment, we're on sharp. If I wind it over, you hear how it rounds out a bit? So it tricks the amp sim software into thinking that it's seeing the input of, you know, a standard sort of a tube amp, which is pretty cool. If I run this preamp control down on Pure, you won't get that JFET coloration. As opposed to, very subtle, but it adds something nice to the mid-range and a bit of roundness. So that's input 1. It also selects between active and passive, so if you're using active pickups on your bass or AMGs or something like that, you can attenuate that control with the active and passive switch, the JFET and the Pure switch, as we've already spoken about. Input 2 has an instrument input as well. On the rear, you'll find repeats of these inputs, 1 and 2, for XLR and or unbalanced inputs, line or instrument, however you like to call it. And you can see that it's working fine because I'm using it for my microphone. And by the way, we're tracking at 64 samples, so there's no issue with latency. It's very good. There's a little preset control on the front that will let you go into Amplitube and select different presets. That's kind of very cool, but it can actually be assigned to anything you want from within the controller software, which I will show you right now. And there it is, and you can see my voice nattering on here in input 2, but you've got a readout for input 1, and it pretty much control over everything you want, including the sample rates, the direct monitoring, and then if you go to the controller page over here, the MIDI channels that are assigned to this preset control, so you can, you know, assign them to control whatever you want, really. It just becomes a controller. And there's this very clever little amp output input here. I call it an amp output input because you can stick an unbalanced lead into there and then use the direct signal going through the Axe I/O to re-amp your amplifier, or use some amp sim software like Amplitube, for instance. So there's a reamp function on it as well. On the rear, we've got the power control, we've got MIDI in and out, we've got USB 2 to control the interface and the audio stream. Then we've got two expression pedal inputs, which again you can assign with the controller software right here. So if you want to control a wah or, you know, channel switching or whatever, you can do all of that and assign them to be momentary or latching or, you know, all sorts of stuff. Then we've got the four outputs, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, and then the combi inputs. It's a very clear sounding device. It's very quick. It doesn't have any latency to speak of. And as I said, I'm tracking at 64 samples right here and now. It's not expensive, and it's built specifically for guitar players to use with this Z-tone control, which I think is a very, very cool thing. I'm just going to run this neck pickup again and have another listen to that. I back it off. It's the Axe I/O from IK Multimedia, and I think they've done a wonderful job of offering something that is extremely usable to us guitar players. Check one out. See ya.